Have you ever eaten a piece of chocolate and wondered to yourself, how on earth is this delicious dessert actually made? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
It turns out it's quite the process to make chocolate. Those sweet treats start out as cocoa beans growing on a tree. These beans are actually the seeds of the cocoa tree. The pods, called chorrels, can be all different colors, from bright yellow to deep purple. They have about 20 to 60 seeds inside, each about an inch long and covered in a sticky white pulp. The very first step in making chocolate is to carefully scoop out those sticky beans, cover them with banana leaves, then put them inside shallow boxes so they can ferment. Fermentation is a natural chemical reaction where yeast or bacteria breaks down the sugar and turns it into something more acidic, like vinegar. For the cocoa beans, it's the sticky white pulp that starts to ferment. This can take anywhere from 3 to 9 days. Once the beans fully transform to a dark brown color, they're spread out on mats and left in the sun to dry out. This takes between a few days and a few weeks. Once they're nice and dry, the dried and fermented beans are packed into sacks and shipped off to chocolate factories around the world. At the factory, the beans first get roasted. This helps kill off any leftover bacteria and also helps to develop the flavor, bringing out the special chocolatey smell and taste even more. After roasting, the bean is cracked open by a machine and the cocoa nibs are removed. Powerful fans blow away all the lighter shell pieces, leaving just the pure pieces of cocoa behind. Those nibs are then ground into a deep, dark brown paste called cocoa mass that smells great and tastes a bit like super buttery, bitter chocolate. Some of this cocoa mass is kept for later. The rest is pressed in a machine that squeezes all the cocoa butter out of the paste, leaving behind a flat, dry cake that's ground into a powder like you might use in hot chocolate. The hunk of cocoa mass from before is mixed with the cocoa butter that was squeezed out. Then plenty of sugar is added. Sometimes other ingredients are thrown in too, like milk, vanilla, nuts, or other flavors. The chocolate blend is then sent through rollers to work out impurities and make the chocolate as perfectly smooth as possible. Finally, the concoction is heated and cooled over and over in a special process called tempering that keeps the chocolate looking nice as it dries into its final form. Whew, that's a lot of steps. It turns out that making chocolate is, well, kinda hard. Eating it, on the other hand, well, that's the easy part.